One of the best ways to hit your opponent is to feint and then throw the punch. Ryan, you couldn't say it better.
You know, we're doing a drill right now where my outlaws are feinting punches and trying to land.
Okay.
And, you know, you think of the word feint, it sounds a lot like the word fake, and people that are not accustomed to boxing usually think that's what you're saying, but you're actually saying shank. But it is like faking. And what you're trying to do is you're trying to read your opponent and how they're reacting to a particular punch or movement or piece of defense or anything that you do, and you're trying to use that against them. Now, in boxing, when you're just in your regular boxing stance and you're doing all the things you should do, like have your elbows in and your hands up, you're pretty difficult to hit, okay? And it's not until you commit to something, whether it's punching, whether it's moving, whether it's defending, that you actually open yourself up and be vulnerable. Now, you know, it's a double-edged sword. You have to commit if you wish to win the fight, but that commitment is also what's gonna expose you. The feint is a great way to help expose your opponent, to help them commit to something that's false, so you can take advantage of them with something that's real. So right now what the Outlaws are doing up here is, one of them is leading with the jab. Leading with the jab. Leading with the jab. And when they feel like they have their opponent figured out properly, they're showing them the jab, they're coming with the hook. Hopefully, when they go for this movement, our Outlaws on the defensive end will maybe have reached a little too far for the parry or slipped a little too far against a false shot, and thus exposing themselves to that. Now, what can you feint in boxing? Well, certainly you can feint punches, right? But here's the thing. Anything you can do in the ring, you can pretend to do in the ring as well. So it doesn't only have to be feinting punches. You can feint movement. You can feint defense. You can pretend like you're about to block here and do something there. I can pretend like I'm going to step here and really step there. Hey, I can feint like I'm tired and I'm vulnerable, and then I can spring a trap on you.
I've seen people do that.
Sure.
You know what Canelo does? He throws his left hand straight out to the side of his body, and he comes and hits you with the other hand. Because your head movement looks like, where's my hand going?
Well, hey, that leads us to another good thing about feinting, because you as the feinter, you're trying to study your opponent and see what they're studying on you and use this against them. So, of course, look, I can throw the jab at you, Ellie, and I can feint the jab and get you to react to that.
Yeah.
But I can do this too, Ellie. I can throw the jab with a little bravado. Ha! Ha! Maybe make a face.
Yeah.
Ha! Step on the ground. Get you to start thinking about inconsequential things. And then maybe I wouldn't even have to throw that jab to feint you. I could just go, ha! Throw the sound at you and get you to react.
That's a good point.
You try to get your opponent to pick up on things that really don't have anything to do with what your master plan is.
And
that's one of the beautiful things about the feint.
One punch?
It only takes one.
So there you have it. Feinting. What's the best one someone got you with? That really, like in basketball, when you do a crossover, they say they faked you out of your shoes.
I can't think of one in particular, but when you get feinted and countered because of it, you know you've been tricked. You know it, and you're like, you got to give that person props. Maybe a couple months after the fight, but eventually you got to give them their props.
One I saw recently in a gym, two guys were sparring, and one guy was tired, so he told the other person he's sparring, like he pointed at his shoes, like the shoes untied. So the guy looked down.
Yeah. You know, one of my favorite things to do is I'll start attacking the body. And I'll be really weird about it. I'll look at the body.
Yeah.
And then I'll attack the body. I'll look at the body and attack the body. And then one of my favorite ones is just looking down, boom, and coming over the top. Because that's the type of things that opponents start picking up on you. Where your eyeballs are going. Where's your head movement going? How do you sound?
Like,
if I felt like an opponent was picking up on my breathing pattern, I would feint my breathing pattern to fool them. Anything that I know my opponent is studying on me, I'm, in my best interest, going to try to use it against them to my advantage.
That's why they say it's like a chess game.
Yeah,
use your brain. There you have it, Brandon Krause. Thanks for the explanation on feinting. Stay tuned. FeintsReport.com. I'm Melissa, back reporting. Cool.